Dear students, this is the video class which is continued part of the discussion on lithosphere. Through this class, I am going to make you know regarding the rocks and its kinds and the forces on the earth. Rocks are seen by everyone of us. Most of everyone of us are quite familiar with the rocks. So this is a piece of rock it is found in different forms, in different color and in having a different composition. Say, what does rock mean? What are its kinds? The rocks are mainly available on the surface as well as inside the crust, in different layers of the crust. As we find the soil and some other minerals, similarly the rocks are easily available. The rocks are very open on the surface and the rocks are hidden under the soil, and they are in a different types. What do rocks mean? Rocks are inorganic things, inorganic materials, substances, which are available on the surface as well as under the or in different layers of the crust. They are aggregates of the different minerals. In the sense, different kinds of minerals are composed in the rocks. Rocks consisting of different minerals. And the soil, which is mainly available on the surface of the earth, is formed with the withering of the rocks. That is the disintegration of the rock. The rock, due to the temperature, rainfall, humidity, snowfall, wind, due to these processes on the surface of the earth, the solid portion of the earth or the outer part of the earth has been disintegrated, and that has been formed into soil. Soils are of different kinds because they have been formed by the different kinds of rocks. Say, what are the types of rocks? The rocks on the basis of mode of formation, on the basis of mode of formation, or say on the basis of the procedure or the manner of creation or formation of the rocks can be classified classified into three types, or the rocks can be divided into three kinds. They are, one is igneous rocks. Igneous rocks. The second type of the rock is sedimentary rocks. And the third type of rock is metamorphic rock. Metamorphic rocks. See, these are the three kinds of the rocks available on the earth. Igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, metamorphic rocks. The igneous rocks are the primary rocks. They are the basic rocks from which the remaining two types of the rocks have been formed. Say, both the sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks have been formed by igneous rocks. Let us know about igneous rocks. What kind of rocks the igneous rocks are? The word igneous gives us the meaning that fire. Igneous means fire. This word has been derived from either a Latin word called ignis or a Sanskrit word called agni. Both mean fire. Say, igneous rocks are such kind of rocks which are formed by the magma or lava. Magma which is inside the earth, or say in the mantle or in the core, which comes out due to the temperature and pressure, which comes out or which reaches the surface of the earth, it solidifies due to atmosphere, due to coolness, or due to other kind of processes. The lava which comes out on the surface of the earth, it becomes cool and becomes solid. So it takes the form of solids. So such kind of rock, or the rock which is formed in this way out of lava, is said to be igneous rock. Igneous rocks are called primary rocks because they are formed from the molten form of substances or semi-liquid substances or from lava. The igneous rocks are of two types. The igneous rocks are of two types. They are the intrusive igneous rocks. Intrusive igneous rocks. And extrusive igneous rocks. These are the two types of igneous rocks, intrusive and extrusive igneous rocks. What are these intrusive and extrusive igneous rocks? The words themselves give the meaning that intrusive igneous rocks are such kind of igneous rocks which are found inside the crust of the earth. They are not available on the surface of the earth. They are not available on the surface of the earth. They are available inside the crust. How they are formed? When the lava does not reach the surface of the earth, when the lava comes out, some part of lava reaches the surface and it solidifies, and such kind of solid or sediments are called extrusive rocks. But some portion of lava remains in the different layers of the crust and it becomes solid. Gradual solidification takes place. Say, such kind of rocks which have been formed with a very slow process of solidification inside the crust are called intrusive igneous rocks. For example, gabbro, diorite and granites. Such kind of rocks are available in the depth of the crust. And extrusive igneous rocks are available on the surface of the earth, on the land. When lava comes out and reaches the surface, it becomes cool due to wind or the humidity or the coolness in the atmosphere. It becomes solid and they are called the extrusive rocks or extrusive igneous rocks. For example, basalt and andesite. Such kind of rocks are extrusive igneous rocks. The sedimentary rocks. The sedimentary rocks can be called the secondary rocks. Sedimentary rocks are called secondary rocks because they are formed by the igneous rocks. When the igneous rocks break into smaller pieces, or when withering takes place, withering is the disintegration of the rocks, erosion. Say, when igneous rocks erode and they form, of course, through different processes, the sedimentary rocks are formed. Sedimentary rocks, of course, the word sedimentary is derived from a Latin word sedimentum. Sedimentum, which means settling down. I suppose you, the students, must be knowing what does sedimentation mean. Sedimentation is settling down. When you put the mud in water, the mud gradually deposits at the bottom. You take a glass of water, clear or clean glass of water, put mud in the water, the mud mixes up in the water and some part of the soil or the mud, it gradually goes down to the bottom of the glass and it accumulates. So that is what sedimentation. Say, some rocks are formed through this kind of process. That means when the igneous rocks are eroded or withered or they are broken into smaller pieces due to the natural agents like temperature, wind, snowfall, rainfall, rivers, glaciers, etc. They are eroded and they are transported to somewhere and the deposition work takes place. The erosion, transportation and deposition takes place. So when the smaller particles of the igneous rocks get deposited in the floor of the rivers or seas or ocean, lakes, such kind of rocks are formed, sedimentary rocks are formed. The sedimentary rocks are formed through different agencies, say as I have said you, maybe through the wind, water, temperature, etc. Say, when the different layers of the different particles of the igneous rocks are stored, they form into different layers. Some particles, they get solidified through a long period. Of course, they take a very long period to become solid or to get attached one another and they become hard. So, such kind of rocks are sedimentary rocks, or through the rocks which are formed through the process of the sedimentation, are called sedimentary rocks. And the sedimentary rocks can also be called the stratified rocks. Stratified rocks means they are formed in different stratas. Stratas means levels, layers. So they are called stratified rocks. I have said you, the sedimentary rocks are also called secondary rocks because they are formed by the fragments of the igneous rocks. And they are also called, the sedimentary rocks are also called aqueous rocks. Aqueous rocks in the sense, they are formed in the water bodies. They are formed in the water bodies like river bed, in the rivers, lakes, seas, etc. That is why they are called aqueous rocks. Sedimentary rocks can be classified into two types: inorganic sedimentary rocks and organic sedimentary rocks. The sedimentary rocks can be classified into two types as inorganic sedimentary rocks and organic sedimentary rocks. Inorganic and organic sedimentary rocks. Inorganic sedimentary rocks again can be classified into two kinds as mechanically formed inorganic sedimentary rocks and chemically formed inorganic sedimentary rocks. Of course, the inorganic sedimentary rocks are of two kinds. They are mechanically formed inorganic sedimentary rocks and chemically formed inorganic
sedimentary rocks. These are the two kinds of inorganic sedimentary rocks. Mechanically formed inorganic sedimentary rocks and chemically formed inorganic sedimentary rocks. Say, the inorganic rocks or say chemically and mechanically formed inorganic rocks are such kind of sedimentary rocks which are formed by the pre-existing particles of igneous rocks. They formed through the process of erosion, transformation or deposition. Say particularly through the process of sedimentation, these rocks are formed. And chemically formed inorganic substances or inorganic sedimentary rocks or sediments. Sediments mean rocks. Organic sedimentary rocks are formed through a process of evaporation. Evaporation of water containing salts. Say through particular chemical process, when the water is evaporated, the substances containing water and salt, when the water evaporates due to temperature, say such kind of chemically formed sedimentary rocks created. Say for example for such kind of chemically formed sedimentary rocks are coal, and mechanically formed inorganic sediments like sandstone, shale, etc. Similarly, we find organic sedimentary rocks. Organic sedimentary rocks are of two types. They are calcareous organic sedimentary rocks and carbonaceous organic sedimentary rocks. Calcareous organic sedimentary rocks and the carbonaceous organic sedimentary rocks. Calcareous and carbonaceous organic sedimentary rocks. See, organic sedimentary rocks are formed due to the remains of the living organisms. Maybe with the remains or the residues of the animals and plants, or maybe the residues of the marine creatures, or by the shells of the marine organisms. So such kind of rocks are of sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary rocks are of two types, inorganic sedimentary rocks and organic sedimentary rocks. Inorganic sedimentary rocks are of two types. They are mechanically formed inorganic sedimentary rocks and chemically formed inorganic sedimentary rocks. And organic sedimentary rocks are of again two types. They are calcareous sedimentary or organic sedimentary rocks and carbonaceous organic sedimentary rocks. The other type of
or the third type of rocks are metamorphic rocks. The metamorphic rocks, the word itself tells you, metamorphism, or the process of metamorphism means change in the form. Metamorphism means change in the form of the rocks. When the pre-existing rocks in the sense already existing rocks, ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಇದ್ದಂತ ಕಲ್ಲುಗಳು, they change their form due to temperature or pressure. Due to temperature or pressure, some kind of rocks change their form. So, such kind of rocks which are formed through the process of metamorphism are called metamorphic rocks. Say, the metamorphism may be physical or may be chemical. Through a physical change, maybe in color, in hardness, the change may take place. And the chemical composition can also be changed. So, this change is possible in the rocks due to temperature and pressure. Say, the major metamorphic rocks are, of course, the granite changing into gneiss, limestone changing into marble, sandstone changing into quartz, coal changing into graphite, and graphite changing into diamond. Say, in this way, the metamorphic rocks change their form, and the metamorphic rocks are the hardest rocks. They are the hardest rocks. Say, this is what regarding the rocks. Say, now let us move on to know about other aspects related with the crust. Say, you must have seen the topography or the surface features of the earth get changed. Change is the continuous process. The topography or the relief features or the physical features of the earth go on changing. Why this change takes place? Say, you can see that the different physical features on the earth. Say, you may see plains, a very level lands. At some places you may see the hills, mountains, valleys. Say, at other places you can see the water bodies like rivers, lakes, ponds, seas, oceans, straits, gulfs, isthmus, estuaries, such kind of many more landforms, water bodies, or water form means the forms of the water bodies are seen on the surface of the earth. Say, even this whatever the physical features you see at present, they must not have been so before 1 or 2 million years ago. They must have been in the different form. In the sense, where you see the levels, there must have been a hill. Where you can see a very steep valley, say U-shaped valley or W-shaped valley, such kind of valleys, W-shaped valleys or U-shaped valleys. There you may you could have seen the plains, level lands. Say what make or what cause such kind of changes on the surface of the earth? It is the different forces on the earth which cause such kind of changes in the physical features of the earth. The different forces, like it may be wind, the rainfall, snowfall, temperature, or say the earthquakes, volcanoes, tsunamis, such kind of forces have changed the topography of our earth in a long passage of the time, in long span of time. Say, what are these forces which cause in change in the relief features or physical features of the earth? Let us know. Of course, the force under the title Forces of the Crust, under the subtitle of Forces of the Earth's Crust, we will be discussing. Forces of the crust of the earth. The forces on the crust of the earth are of two types. One is the internal forces, and the second one is external forces. Internal forces such as volcanoes, earthquakes, and tsunamis. Tsunami can be regarded as external force too, but it is generated due to the earthquakes. And the external forces such as winds, rivers, temperature, rainfall, snowfall, sea waves, in this major aspect, the temperature, humidity, glaciers, etc. So these external forces cause, both external as well as internal forces cause the changes on the features of the earth, especially on the crust. See, the internal forces are also called endogenic forces. Internal forces are also called endogenic forces. Say, let us know something about the major internal forces of the earth or the crust of the earth. Firstly, let us know about volcanoes. a narrow opening, a narrow opening or vent which connects the magma chamber inside the earth, through which the volcanic substances like ashes, gas, some liquids, say in the form of lava, comes out and reaches the surface of the earth with the huge force and temperature. It is called volcano. See, for example, volcano is, it is a narrow opening. Say a narrow opening from just in that, this is the surface of the earth. The magma which is present inside the earth, or say in the mantle or the core, this magma, due to the centrifugal force or due to the temperature and the pressure, it tries to comes out. It tries to comes out through any weaker part of the earth. The magma tries to come out through any openings or through any weaker part of the crust. So when an opening is created, or when a vent or pipe or a passage is created through the crust, the magma comes out with a lot of force, and it comes out with high force in the form of the huge mountain or bombs, and reaches the surface, and when it reaches the surface, it gradually cools down in a long span of time. So this is what a volcano. Volcano is a narrow opening or a vent, V-E-N-T, vent, vent through which magma reaches the surface of the earth. So this kind of natural force is called a volcano. Say, the volcanoes cause earthquakes too. They cause many other destructions on the earth. Before knowing that, let us know about the kinds of volcanoes. Volcanoes, on the basis of the frequency of eruption. Eruption in the sense, emitting or lava coming out, the process of lava coming out, or something, some kind of liquids coming out, is said to be eruption or emitting. Say, on the periodicity or frequency of the eruptions of the volcanoes can be classified into three kinds, as the active volcanoes, dormant volcanoes, and extinct volcanoes. The three kinds of volcanoes are, one is active volcanoes, dormant volcanoes, and extinct volcanoes. The active volcanoes are such kind of volcanoes which are active even today, which are erupting even today. since their origin. Such kind of volcanoes are called active volcanoes. They are constantly active. There are about 600 active volcanoes on the earth. The major active volcanoes on the earth are Mount Stromboli and Mount Etna in Italy, and St. Helens in USA, and Pinatubo in Philippines. These are the major active volcanoes. There may be still many other active volcanoes, but these are the major active volcanoes on the earth. And dormant volcanoes are such kind of volcanoes which have become silent since a very long duration. The volcanoes which were active in the past, but they have become inactive at present. But they are likely to erupt in the future. They are the volcanoes which are inactive, and there may be the possibility of becoming active or erupting in the future. Such kind of volcanoes are said to be dormant volcanoes. The major dormant volcanoes on the earth are Mount Vesuvius in Italy, Mount Fujiyama in Japan, Kilimanjaro in Tanzania, and Krakatoa in Indonesia. These are the major dormant volcanoes. And extinct volcanoes, the word extinct means which are no more in active state, means which have become completely inactive. Such kind of volcanoes are called inactive volcanoes. So the inactive volcanoes are extinct volcanoes. Extinct volcanoes are such kind of volcanoes which have become inactive since their origin, since their beginning. In the sense, once they were originated, but since then there won't be any history or any instance that they have become active in the past. Say maybe in the span of 200 years or 300 years, they have become totally inactive. Such kind of volcanoes are called inactive or extinct volcanoes. The examples of the extinct volcanoes are Gorongoro in Tanzania and Arthur's Seat in Scotland. Such kind of volcanoes in the different form we find on the earth. See, what are the substances found through the volcanic eruptions? Volcanoes can bring. Volcano is the magma coming out through a particular passage and reaching the surface of the earth. Say, while it comes out, while magma comes out, it brings out so many solids, liquids, as well as gases. Many kinds of these things comes out with large or with great force, and the temperature would be very high. So the solids, liquids, and the gases are the major substances. Among solids, the volcanic bombs, cinders, scoria, fumes, dust, ash, etc. These things come out. And the liquids, the lava, which is containing all these things, it comes out in the form of lava, or it will be in the liquid state. And the different gases like sulfur, hydrogen, carbon dioxide comes out through volcanic eruptions. The major reasons of volcanoes on the earth, major reasons of volcanoes on the earth are the coastal regions of the Pacific Ocean. The coastal regions of Pacific Ocean. Of course, the Asian coast of Pacific Ocean and the western coast of North America as well as South America are the major regions. Along with that, of course, that portion is called Circum-Pacific Belt or Pacific Ring of Fire. Pacific Ring of Fire or Circum-Pacific region. And the Mid-Atlantic Belt. The Mid-Atlantic Belt is this portion. This region is also known for volcanoes. Say the Iceland and Caribbean Islands, that is West Indies. And Mid-Continental Belt. Mid-Continental Belt like these European countries. Italy, Spain, Greece, France, Turkey. This region is also prone to volcanoes. And some islands like Hawaii Islands and Philippines. Say the Philippines and the Hawaii Islands in the Pacific Ocean are the volcanic prone zones on the earth. So I suppose this is enough regarding the volcanoes. Say the another major internal force of the crust is earthquake. What is earthquake? Why it is caused? Let us concentrate on this aspect now. Say you, some of you must have experienced or not the earth due to earthquake. Some kind of tremors or say shakes take place on the surface of the earth, due to which lot of loss to the property and lives happen. See, what are these earthquakes? Earthquake is nothing but it is a series of shocks or tremors. Kampanagalu. Series of shocks or tremors due to the sudden movement of the crustal rocks. Crustal rocks in the sense, the rocks present in the crust. Say, I have said to you, the earth is having these three layers. Say, the crust, which is for about 60 to 100 kilometers. Say, the continental crust is thick, the oceanic crust is thin. And down to that we have the mantle, and the innermost layer is core, mantle, and crust. Say, this crust, the outermost layer of the earth, the crust, this layer is predominantly made in form of so many rocks or plates of rocks, or we can call them as tectonic plates, tectonic slabs of the rocks. Such kind of slabs of the rocks are formed in the crust. Say, due to the sudden movement of these crustal rocks, I said you the crust is in solid portion, whereas the mantle and core are in the molten form. Say, these the crustal rocks, they are not stationary. They may change their place and position. Means they do not move like vehicles, but there will be very slight displacement. See, due to that, due to some sudden changes in the position of the crustal rocks, some kind of tremors take place. Tremors in the sense changes on the other slabs of the rocks take place, and that causes the tremors on the surface of the earth. On the surface of the earth, whatever the installations, say the buildings, etc., or say any kind of reservoirs, they collapse. The man-made installations develop into, of course, they develop cracks, or their foundations shake. That is why they fall down. So this is what the earthquake. The earthquake is one of the major internal force of the earth, cause in the change of the topography or the physical features of the earth. Say, regarding earthquake, say, I said you, the earthquake is caused due to some reasons. The causes of the earthquake. What are the causes of the earthquake? One is plate tectonics, or change in the crustal rocks, or change in the plate tectonics, or crustal rocks. The second one is volcanic eruptions. Volcanic eruptions. Due to volcanoes, the earthquakes take place. Earthquakes happen. Then faulting. Faulting. Due to faulting, or say cracks developed into the different crustal rocks, the earthquakes happen, earthquakes occur. And due to some man-made factors, cause the earthquakes to occur. Say, the change in plate tectonics are crustal rocks, say due to the gradual displacement or change in the position of the huge slabs of the rocks in the crust, the earthquakes cause. And volcanoes, as we have already come to know that, due to the volcanoes, the earthquakes happen. The volcanoes cause tremors in the surrounding areas. So, the earthquakes take place. Faulting. Faulting is a kind of crack, or say a gap develops in the crustal rocks that cause into the earthquake. And man-made factors. The man-made factors are man-made causes include the deep mining or underground explosions, say nuclear tests, etc., made under the ground or under the earth, or they may be made in the oceans too, and the building of huge reservoirs or dams, mining, underground explosions, these building of the reservoirs are the major man-made factors which cause in the earthquakes to happen, earthquakes to occur. Say, the earthquakes cause huge destruction on the surface of the earth. They cause in the huge loss of property as well as lives. So many cities and towns may reduce to ground. So due to the collapse of the buildings or such kind of a destruction, say what may cause? The number of loss to the lives may take place, maybe the human beings or animals. And also the earthquakes cause in the floods. Whenever the reservoirs develop into a cracks, of course, whenever the cracks are developed in the reservoirs due to the earthquakes, the reservoirs break down and the water flows into the river basins in large quantity, causing the devastation. So, still many more effects the human beings, including all other living beings, have to face due to the earthquakes. Say, the earthquakes are such kind of internal forces of the earth. They can be, they cannot be avoided, but due to the man-made factors, we can reduce the possibility of the earthquakes to happen. The earth, of course, how do earthquakes take place or happen, and how we come to know the earthquakes? Say, earthquakes cause into some waves, the waves of the earthquakes, which are called seismic waves, earthquake waves. Earthquake waves are seismic waves. The earthquakes and their effects reach the surface of the earth through these waves. So what are these earthquake waves or called the seismic waves? The earthquake waves can be of three kinds. One is the primary waves. Second is secondary waves. And the third one is surface. Surface waves. These are the three kinds of earthquake waves. The primary, secondary, and surface waves. The primary waves are also called longitudinal or compressional waves. Longitudinal or compressional waves. Secondary waves are also called transverse or distortional waves. And the surface waves are called long waves. They are called with different names. Say, what kind of waves are primary waves? What kind of waves are secondary and surface waves? Let us see. Say, when the faulting takes place or any kind of displacement in the crustal rocks takes place, the shocks are generated, a kind of cracks or tremors, shocks, component, they take place. Say, these waves travel to the surface. These waves travel to the surface. And such kind of waves which travel from the hypocenter to the epicenter of the earth are called primary waves. Hypocenter means the point of the earthquake inside the crust. The point of the earthquake inside the crust, or where the displacement or faulting has taken place in the plate tectonics, is called, of course, that particular place or the point or the spot inside the crust where that kind of change has taken place is called hypocenter. Hypocenter. Hypocenter of the earthquake, the point inside the earth's crust, of the point inside the earth's crust regarding the earthquake. The earthquake point inside the earth's crust is called hypocenter. So, from the hypocenter, some waves travel on all directions. They move in all directions. Say, when these waves reach the surface of the earth, so the waves which originate from the hypocenter and reach the surface of the earth, such kind of waves are called primary waves. After the primary waves reaching the surface, or the primary waves are followed by the secondary waves, which also originate from the hypocenter. And the place vertically above the hypocenter on the surface of the earth is called epicenter. Epicenter of the earthquake. Epicenter is the point on the surface of the earth vertically above the hypocenter. Say, from the epicenter, the waves travel horizontally on the surface of the earth, which are called as surface waves. Surface waves are more destructional in nature. They are more dangerous comparing to the primary and secondary waves. The primary and secondary waves originate from the hypocenter and they reach the surface. After that, the surface waves scatter. They move horizontally from the epicenter towards the adjoining areas. So, they cause great loss on the surface of the earth. See? They cause in the collapse of the installations, man-made establishments. So this is what regarding the earthquake. I suppose you must be knowing that the earthquake, its intensity, the time, place, direction of the seismic waves. All these can be measured through a particular instrument called seismograph or seismogram. And the intensity of the earthquake is measured in a particular scale which is called Richter scale. And the scientific study of earthquake is called seismology. So this is as regards with the earthquake. And the earthquakes also cause for tsunamis. You know, tsunami. What does a tsunami mean? Sorry. Tsunami is such kind of natural force which causes a very huge loss on the coastal areas. Say tsunami is a Japanese word, gives the meaning that harbor waves. Harbor waves, harbor means port, pivot. The earthquakes which originate, the earthquakes which occur in the floor of the seas or oceans or say any islands, they cause tremors in the particular place where the earthquake has taken place in that sea or ocean. Say the effect of that earthquake happen on the water of the seas or ocean. Say the water of the sea or ocean gets disturbed, and this causes, gets disturbed in the sense the calm quiet water, it gets disturbed from the bottom where the earthquake has taken place. So the huge waves are created on the surface of the seas or ocean. They travel or they move in such a speed to reach the coast. They cause a very huge loss on the coastal areas. Especially the tsunamis are quite common on the eastern coast of Asia, especially on the coast of Japan and on these islands, Philippines, Japan. Say there we can experience frequent tsunamis. So these are the internal forces of the earth's crust. Regarding external forces, say regarding the rivers, glaciers, sea waves, rainfall, temperature, and all these things, we will be having the discussion in another video class. Thank you.